Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Assassin's Creed. Last time, we got the information we needed on our target, and we got the okay to separate the soul from the rest of his body. Now, as for the actual location of this target, I don't usually talk about this, but I will do it this time just because, for first-time players, and I don't know who's playing this for the first time, considering there are 3, 4, 5, 6 of these out. But yeah, the location for this particular person is annoying. The actual assassination isn't that hard, but the actual getting to him is rather tedious. And for those of you who have gotten all the viewpoints, we'll be taking the exact path to one of the viewpoints to get to our target. Now, you may be wondering where this location is, considering that there were a lot of viewpoints scoured throughout the entire city. Give it a minute. Because there's only one area that's big enough and open enough to house a military master! Ah, I love it when they can't scream. Alright, so, moving on. I can't think of anything else to say. Oh, hey, somebody commented on one of the challenge modes in Time Splitters Future Perfect. I've noticed that those videos have been getting a lot of love lately, and I don't know why, but yeah, alright. You guys like the challenge modes. I can accept that. And that's what happened. Hey! If you're gonna shoot arrows at me, the least you could do is, you know, die. Alright, so this is where we need to go.
Souls, William. I was told they would be held as prisoners and used to barter for the release of our men.
The Saracens would not have honored that end of the bargain. You know this to be true. I did you a favor.
Oh, yes. A great favor indeed. Now our enemies will be that much stronger in their convictions. Fight that much harder.
I know our enemy well. They will not be emboldened, but filled with fear.
Tell me, how is it you know the intentions of our enemies so well? You who forsake the field of battle to play at politics?
I did what was right. What was just?
You swore an oath to uphold the work of God, William. But that is not what I see here. No. I see a man who's trampled it.
Your words are most unkind, my liege. I would hope I might have earned your trust by now.
You are Arca's regent, William, set to rule in my stead. How much more trust is required? Perhaps you'd like my crown.
You missed the point. But this is nothing new.
Much as I'd like to waste my day trading words with you, I've a war to fight. We'll have to continue this another time.
Do not let me delay you then, Your Grace. I fear there will be no place for men like him in the new world. Send word that I wish to speak with the troops. We must ensure that everyone is doing their part. Warn them that any negligence will be severely punished. I'm in no mood to be trifled with today.
Yes, my lord.
The rest of you, follow me.
Oh, a heated conversation in between the regent and the king himself. Well, we know what happens when that happens. So, this should be an easy assassination. Well, in theory, anyway. Your biggest obstacle in this particular assassination is going to be scaling the frickin' castle. Because you can't just run in the front door. You have to be creative about this and figure out a way up that will allow you the best vantage point to take out your target! Damn it! Okay, let's try that again. Throughout the climb, you'll possibly hear him, especially when you get to one particular point, which is, I think is when the audio is supposed to cue in, but I've seen it cue in a couple of different places. I don't know if that's just the different versions of the game, or possibly programming errors, or possibly just something completely not connected to either one of those, but for some reason, I've heard him before I'm supposed to hear him a couple of times, so yeah. And for anyone that's interested, how many times I've actually played and beaten this game, I think this Let's Play actually marks my 7th time going through this game. It's not even my favorite Assassin's Creed game gameplay-wise, but it is my, as mentioned, I think this is the best story-wise because, well, a lot of questions weren't already answered, like the Templars being giant dicks and the Assassins kind of being more minuscule-esque dicks just playing the hero card. Though, again, perspective really equals good and evil in this franchise, so yeah. I'm gonna let you hear what he actually says to his troops while you're scaling the walls, and then I'll show you the actual assassination.
Assassin! Kill him!
It's easy to find faults, to see imperfection.
You have no business.
I feel black and lazy.
Never. We are committed.
Why do you say this?
I see the way you train. You lack conviction and focus. Gossip and gamble. Tasks set to you are left unfulfilled or poorly performed. This ends today. I will not suffer further degradation at his hands. For whether or not you see it, and you should, this is your fault. You've brought shame upon us all. Skill and dedication are what won us up.
Okay, so I'm gonna be completely honest with you. I don't know what happened. They're not actually supposed to see you up there, as demonstrated in a second. It's just, I don't know. But yeah, he pretty much goes on like that for about, if I remember right, 5 minutes. It's just an insane amount of time to be complaining at someone, and you can listen to the entire conversation within the sound file. It's honestly kind of amazing. One knife. Ah! I wanted to be awesome. Okay, bring it. Yes, children, this was back in the day before the enemy telegraphed their attack. By a little blinking dot that the designers made because they thought it would be easier to see rather than a sword swing. Not to say the combat hasn't been refined in the later games, it's just I find it annoying that they did that, even though it's helpful. Alright, so, as you're clearly going to see right here, I'm going to attempt to find a place where I can air assassinate this guy, but I am just a little bit too high. What you want to do is you want to fall down onto this scaffolding down here. You're not going to be able to get him from up here. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to get on the scaffolding. Now, it's going to start blinking red instantly when you get down there. You want to air assassinate as quickly as you can, like so.
Rest now. Your schemes are at an end.
What do you know of my work?
I know that you are going to murder Richard and claim Akka for your son, Conrad.
For Conrad? My son is an arse, unfit to lead his host, let alone a kingdom. And Richard, the Ancino, is no better. Blinded as he is by faith in the insubstantial, Akka does not belong to either of them.
Then who?
The city belongs to its people.
How can you claim to speak for the citizens? You stole their food, disciplined them without mercy, forced them into service under you.
Everything I did to prepare them for the new world. Stole their food? No. I took possession so that when the lean times came, it might be rationed properly. Look around. My district is without crime, save those committed by you and your ilk. And as for the conscription, they were not being trained to fight. They were being taught the merits of order and discipline. These things are hardly evil.
No matter how noble you believe your intentions, these acts are cruel and cannot continue.
We'll see how sweet they are, the fruits of your labors. You do not free the cities as you believe, but rather damn them. And in the end, you'll have only yourself to blame. You, who speak of good intentions.
Close the gate!
And now it's time to GTFO as quickly as possible. I do want to say one thing about that conversation. That's probably the best example that this game, or pretty much any other that comes to my memory, gives of the different views of both the Assassins and the Templars. It's not really good and evil, it's order and chaos versus slavery and freedom, if you get what I mean by that. The Templars see order as a good thing, and will just gets in the way of that. So they see freedom as just utter chaos. When people are left to their own devices, everything will always devolve into madness. That's why they want to instill order. The Assassins, however, see will as, well, a good thing. People aren't inherently good, but it's better for them to rule themselves than it is for somebody to just be shouting orders at them. Kind of ironic when you realize that they have an entire system based with a Grandmaster Assassin, but whatever. That should clue in on some little problems with the Assassin Order. But they don't see freedom and will as a bad thing. In fact, they value freedom higher than anything else. So they see order as pretty much enslavement to someone. It's just kind of an odd thing because it's not something that you would think about on a regular basis, I guess. I find it interesting. And that's why I find this game as particularly the best, because this doesn't feel like a bunch of old men in robes plotting to take over the world. This sounds like a bunch of men who truly believe they are doing the right thing, and not just trying to enslave all of humanity. But anyway, we killed our target, now time to get back to the Abbey, which is right here.
What news?
William of Montferrat is dead, and with him his plans for betrayal.
You've done well keeping Akka from his hands.
But why now, when the Crusaders require unity most? He could have waited.
Waited for what? For Richard to return and discover his schemes? No. It was the perfect time for him to strike.
Strange. I was sure he meant to take Akka for Conrad, yet he claimed this was not his plan.
You cannot trust the words of a snake, which even in death produces venom.
I should discuss this with Al-Muallim.
Yes, my friend. Make haste for Masiaf. I am sure he is eager for news.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
And next time, we will be going to talk to Al-Muallim to discuss what we have learned from this latest target. Later.